a great filmmaker implants things inside of your experience that then they don't leave, and they infect your dreams, I guess, like work on that subconscious level that dreams also work on. I would say that what films can bring to our lives is like this kind of surprise and wonder and magic that dreams bring. It was a very literary household, and I loved books. 100 Years of Solitude had a big impact. Wind Up Bird Chronicle had a big impact. You know, oh, here's a film that really actually was Spirited Away. I just remember seeing that film and being like, wow, you know, a dragon can be made up of 1,000 paper birds, you know? Like a monster can become a mother. God, Miyazaki is such a genius. Like Howl's Moving Castle, I just think is so good. And how this little girl inhabits the body of like a 90 something year old woman. I feel like he's touching on something that I saw Garcia Marquez touching in 100 Years of Solitude, which is like, it's almost like it's more real because of the exaggerated reality of the world. Because I think we move through life with this sense like, I can't change the world around me. You know, it can feel like that. And the world around you can be sometimes very much at odds with like your intentions or your expectations. And so I think when you exist in a magical realist world, you're kind of getting at that it doesn't always feel like everything fits. Even if all you're doing is like waking up and going to your job every day, the world can have its own intention on you. So I think I really respond to those kinds of films and filmmakers and those kind of writers too. In a way, I started relatively late for filmmakers. I think a lot of people start in their teens. I was like 22 when I started seriously thinking about it. That I also just had this knowledge that like you can kind of do anything. If you get trained in it, you can do anything. So I started working at ABC News Productions like right out of college as a PA. And it was a big job actually. It's like their documentary arm. It was like an AP, a PA, and a producer are like making a whole show. So the PA provides all the visual content for the film and is like most in touch with the editor. So in a way, you're kind of an assistant editor more than you're a PA. So I learned a lot about editing through that and just about storytelling and writing in general. So that was a great experience. So I would say that my intention to become a filmmaker, I was like 22, but I think the interest had been lurking for a lot longer than that. I just follow whatever I'm curious about. So whatever like excites me and then that I kind of can't stop thinking about and I end up writing in my journal or reading books about, that's usually what I end up making movies about. And it's interesting, this next film I'm gonna make is it's sort of about the prison system. And I was held up at gunpoint on my front stoop like 3 years ago. And that was kind of what the spark of this interest, because the guy was so nervous, he was 19. He took all my, I mean, I gave him all my money. Obviously, if somebody's pointing a gun at you, you just give them what they want. But I remember thinking, like, I could take this guy. Like, if I wanted to, he's scrawny. Like, you know, and he was a little scared. So anyway, he takes the money. He takes my phone as well. But my roommate was home. When I went inside, like, the door was a little bit ajar. I ran in. We called the police, and they caught him. It turns out that he'd gotten out of jail, like, the day before. And now it was armed robbery, so there's a minimum sentence, actually, even though it turns out the gun was fake. So I think what I'm trying to say is that because the question is, how do you choose the projects? Okay. That I think it's really nice to choose just the thing that is stewing around your brain. That incident has been stewing with me. Like, what happened to him? And did I negatively affect his whole life by calling the police? And, like, I didn't think twice about calling the police, but then when they caught him, I was like, oh, shit. But it was interesting, like, when we sat down on the grass that day, I asked my mom, like, how do you choose the projects that you work on? And she was like, I think about what is the largest issue that society has that I could actually have an impact on, and then I try to solve that problem. So she worked for a long time in nuclear nonproliferation and child abuse stuff before that and death penalty stuff before that. And so... yeah, and now she's kind of working on like economic infrastructure in countries that like need more energy resources. So it's different approaches, but yeah, mine is usually just my curiosity. don't wait until you have money. Don't wait. Really don't. Because, like, ideas are fleeting and passion is fleeting. And if you feel really passionate, like, you want to make that project, even if it's a crazy, lofty, apocalyptic, you know, like, you're going to need $10 million at the least, you know, and you've got to talk to eight. Steven Spielberg's got to be executive producing or the movie's not going to be successful. Constraint is a huge gift, I think, in film. And that if you can figure out how to make the apocalyptic movie for a tiny budget, that's magic. And people are dying to see that. Like, we know what an apocalyptic movie on a $100 million budget looks like. People are doing that and getting paid a lot. And the movies are usually not that great because they're $100 million and everyone and their kid has to sign off on the, like, that film. And when you make the movies for nothing, nobody is looking over your shoulder. And you find your voice. Like, you get to be you. And not feel the constraint of fitting into a paradigm. So I feel really lucky to have spent time working with Joe Swanberg on his films as an actor, and just seeing somebody who wasn't really afraid to make movies for very little, to make movies that weren't necessarily always entertaining even, and just realize, like, I can start exploring myself as a director without all that infrastructure and without the $1 million and without, like, the big yes in check form. And so I would say for young filmmakers to just make the work in however you can, even if it means modifying your vision or saving the apocalypse until, like, you know, you're in your 40s, like, but to really nurture yourself and make that art, because there is something that happens every time you direct a movie. It's like, people look to you for answers for a lot of things. They want to know what you think about costumes, and the actors want feedback, and you're running experience for people. And I think that the more times you do that, just the better you get at it. And then when you hopefully, you know, have opportunities that are with support, you just have a stronger handle on how to get what you want and how to ask for what you want. It is so important. It is so important to have a good cinema and film program at universities. I mean, it's not a sadness exactly, but it's like Princeton, after I graduated, they really put a lot of effort into the arts, and it's a much stronger program than it was when I was there. And even though I got actually great exposure to a lot of opportunities, and in some ways I'm really glad that I got to focus on literature, there wasn't a lot of opportunity to study film as a filmmaker. There was, like, a videography course taught by an experimental filmmaker, and she's really interesting, but I think at the time I was much more interested in, like, the structure and just how do you tell, like, a commercial story, because I knew that I wasn't good at that, that was the thing I would have needed shaping on, versus just, like, you know, whoa, film like the sky, and then, like, I guess, anyway, that's what I ended up doing. Now I'm, like, very experimental, but I think it would have been nice to have that training, that background and structure. I think I've been learning it as I go. There's something beautiful about learning from doing. But I think a great cinema program, which my feeling about IU is that it's a great film program, like, that the people here are challenged intellectually and emotionally to create art that is, like, breaking open boundaries, and that there's a lot of institutional support for making work. So the PhD students I've met here have been, like, just seem really excited, and they're passionate, and they're teaching, and they're making, and that's such a gift. It's a gift to the undergrads too, that then get to see and explore themselves, like, through mentors. And yeah, I think it's really nice to have a good cinema studies program.